An open mic during last week's G20 summit caught President Obama and French President Nicolas Sarkozy complaining about Israel's prime minister, according to a report by Reuters. "I cannot bear Netanyahu. He's a liar," said Sarkozy. Obama, according to a French interpreter who was translating his remarks, replied, "You're fed up with him, but I have to deal with him even more often than you." The president didn't exactly come to the defense of Netanyahu, whom he most recently saw at the UN in September. "It's not surprising," says Martin Indyk, who served as U.S. ambassador to Israel during the Clinton and Bush administrations.
"It reveals the inner feelings of the president towards Prime Minister Netanyahu. I don't think it's any secret that these two leaders have not gotten on, basically, from their first meeting on."
And an Oval Office encounter this past May further revealed the frosty relationship between the leaders.
"While Israel is prepared to make generous compromises for peace, it cannot go back to the 1967 lines."
Netanyahu essentially lecturing a stern-faced President Obama. Today, White House Press Secretary Jay Carney, in an off-camera briefing, would not comment on the open mic gaffe. He instead stressed the president's support of Israel, most recently in opposing a vote to give the Palestinian Authority membership in the UN's cultural agency, UNESCO, a move France supported.
"America's commitment to Israel's security is unshakable."
It's an embarrassing incident as both the U.S. and Israel keep a close eye on regime changes in the Middle East and on the growing threat of a nuclear Iran. But, says Indyk, it may have no real effect on U.S.-Israel relations.
"It's unlikely that these personality differences that have been highlighted by this mic that wasn't turned off are going to infect the coordination on Iran. If you like, the subject is too serious to be affected by personalities. They agree on the nature of the threat, and they also agree on the way to deal with it, that is by ratcheting up sanctions."
Of course, this does give ammunition to President Obama's critics, namely Republicans, who have said he hasn't backed Israel enough. We've heard from the pro-Israel advocacy group, the Anti-Defamation League, expressing disappointment and saying this was an unpresidential exchange. Brianna Keilar, CNN, the White House.